Simon, I can remember when we had a chat at Park Hall some time ago, you hung up your boots. Well, only as far as the new Saints were concerned, because you played for Airbus UK Broughton in the second tier of Welsh football.
As far as I was convinced I was going to retire and I'd had enough, I was going to stay at TNS full time. I did manage about 4 months, I think it was, so I'd done all pre-season where I didn't play, and then the European game started coming round and I started to miss it again. So I got a phone call off Shosh one day asking me that I want to come in, and I think he caught me on a good day, to be fair. I said, yeah, I'll come in and train and enjoyed the training session and ended up signing about 2 weeks later.
And after all those years at the New Saints, full-time professional, part of a very good side, what was it like going into the second tier?
Really enjoyed it, to be fair. Shosh was great with me. We trained 2 nights a week, so something I'd never done before, but it actually worked out well because I was full-time here with TNS. So it was good. I really enjoyed it. I think just doing the part-time helped me a lot as well. I think the last year or two I was here, I was getting a few injuries, so just taking it down a little bit really helped me.
And obviously, you moved almost immediately into coaching with the New Saints and with the first team as well. As did that seamless transition help with the fact that you weren't a full-time player anymore?
Well, I was already coaching while I was playing, so for the last 2 years I was playing for TNS. I was already doing what I'm doing now, so I knew I was it's what I wanted to do after I finished playing. So it was quite an easy transition, to be fair. It was just that I wasn't playing football in the morning, so it'd be I'd do coaching in the morning with the first team, then I'd go on to do the job I was already doing anyway. So it was an easy transition for me.
And it's certainly encouraging to see all the younger players that are involved with the first team. We're in Llanelli, of course. We have a game tomorrow. Billy Kirkman, Jake Canavan have both travelled, and they're part of the squad because they deserve to be there, not just token youngsters making up the number.
Yeah, we had a good year. Last year we took 9 professionals on, 10 with Gwion as well, who come from Carnarvon, but we had a really good year and we felt that those lads deserved the opportunity or a chance to be involved with the first team, and some of them have took it unbelievable. They've come in and they've been involved with the first team since day one. Others we've put on loan who are doing well at other clubs, so they're doing what they do and showing off to other clubs, and hopefully they'll all be here again next year.
I wanted to mention Gwion actually in particular because he made his debut against Chirk in the Welsh Cup, and then just a few days ago he scored against his old side Carnarvon in the league.
Yeah, we've worked with him. Well, me and Si have worked with him a bit since he's come in from Carnarvon this year. He's been great to work with. Attitude's fantastic, and he's a very good striker. If he gets a chance on goal, it's very rarely misses. So when he does get those opportunities, he is quite clinical.
And you're also coaching the under 21s as well in the reserves, the North East Wales Reserve League. They're doing very well at the moment, like the men's senior first team, only drawn one game, won all the others, flying at the top of the table.
Yeah, we've got a good group of lads, so we usually use our scholars who will play in our reserve team. So they are under 21s. We might probably drop a few older players in now and again, but yeah, we do like that league. We think it's good for the lads. They come out of kids football, and then we do try and throw them into men's football straight away, and it's a good test for them. They'll play against some men who have been around for 10 or 15 years playing football, so it's a different challenge for them. And this year they've took up to it really well.
And the statistics are pretty impressive all round. Scored 50 and conceded just 3.
Yeah, I think this year we've got a group of lads who are fit, run round, and it matters when you're playing in these games. Don't get me wrong, we've got a few good strikers that have been playing as well, and that always helps. Greg scored a few goals, who's come on board of us this year as well. So yeah, we're looking well this year.
Well, I wanted to come to Greg naturally, of course, and yourself, because you thought that you hung up your boots with the New Saints. You didn't. Likewise with Airbus, and now you've got yourself back involved playing with Greg in the under 21s.
Yeah, we found last year that our reserve leagues, well, our under 21s now, they were good football wise, but as for games playing against men, it's that different thing. So they never really had any guidance in it, and it's hard to shout from the side. So I wasn't playing this year, Greg wasn't playing this year, so we decided that we'd you know, we join in with the under 21s and try and help them out a little bit, just get a little bit of experience in with them. And it seems to be working because the lads are taking it, starting to listen, and we feel like it'll be a good experience for them to play with us. You know, Greg's one of the best goal scorers TNS have ever had, so the forward lads can look at him, you know, and then stuff around me as well. Some of the defenders can see what I do, and hopefully they can take something from it.
I guess it works both ways. Not only are the youngsters gaining experience from yourself and Greg, but the two of you as well, you're getting competitive football, which you obviously enjoy.
Yeah, I think once you've played football all your life, you never want it to stop, to be fair. So it's one of them you want to carry on as long as you can. And, you know, well, I know I'm certainly enjoying it. I think Greg's enjoying it as well. He's scored some goals in the last few games. So hopefully it'll be something that we can do for a few years, and little young lads can learn from us.
Well, I was going to ask you, how long do you think you can keep going? Is it as long as your legs allow you to and you still enjoy it?
Well, in my mind, I'm still young enough, yeah, so it's I don't know. Certainly this year, then we'll take it from there, then see how we get on year by year. As long as we feel like we're needed and we've got something to offer, we'll stay and help.
And the last game was a 4-1 victory, and the fourth goal was scored by Greg Draper. And who got the assist? Simon Spender. The two of you rolling back the years to combine there.
Yeah, that's pretty much the story of Greg's career, to be honest. Him standing in the middle of the goal and me passing to him for score. But yeah, he always seems to be in the right place at the right time, so he's always going to get goals.
And ending on another positive note, we've talked about all the youngsters that are involved in the setup in the academy at Park Hall. Do you expect to see more coming through, making debuts in the first team, perhaps getting goals, or at least getting chances?
We'd like to think so, yeah. I think the program that we've got here in the last few years just got better and better. I think the players that we're getting in are getting better and better. And as long as they keep doing well and working hard, then it's shown from this year that the opportunities are there. If the lads are good enough and showing that they want to work, then we're willing to give a chance. You know, there's not many clubs in Wales, go England, Scotland, you travel all around the country. It would take 9 lads on, giving professional contracts, and I want to say 4 or 5 of them at least made their debut this year. The other 4 or 5 have gone out alone, and they're all playing football, you know, in a full time. So it's we feel like the opportunities are there, and, you know, they've got a great chance to start their career off here.